We have got lots of really exciting projects at the moment. We're looking at moving into our first studio at the moment, which is really exciting, building out the team, and just continuing this YouTube grind, making big videos and sort of bridging that gap between Hollywood and social media and sort of bringing those two worlds together.
I mean, obviously, YouTube continues to evolve as a platform. What are you most excited about, and what are you most perhaps concerned about when you look to the future, not just of your channel, but of the platform as a whole?
Wow, that's a really good question, really interesting. I feel like this could be its own feature-length question, but I think the important thing with social media is don't look at any of them as individual platforms that you need to focus on. Branch yourself out and cover as many bases as possible, because YouTube could fall out one day, and you need to make sure you're ready with TikTok and Facebook and all the other platforms to pick it right back up. So as a social media creator, I think it's your responsibility to make sure you're covering your bases on all the platforms. So if one of them does have a little dip one day, you're ready to jump in there on the next one.
Talking about responsibility, obviously there's been a pretty serious ongoing discussion about, as we see YouTube celebrities becoming more of a fixture, particularly of young people's lives, the responsibility that comes with that. I'm curious how you feel about that, and whether or not some of the more headline-grabbing scandals have changed your opinion in any way about that relationship between creators and audiences?
Yeah, it's a really interesting psychology, and it's something I think about all the time, because I think as creators, it's our duty to, you know. People will sit there and watch my content every day, and it genuinely feels like they're hanging out with me, and they feel like they're getting a connection with me, when unfortunately I haven't had the chance to get to meet them yet. So I do feel a responsibility that, I hate the word influencer, but I do have a form of influence on people, and I need to make sure that I'm conveying the right messages to sort of the younger people that might be watching, and make sure it's always giving a positive vibe and sort of helping the world.
And how difficult is it to get the balance right between sharing your personality and your life experiences with your audience and also keeping a private side? Because I know a number of YouTubers, I mean, people like Tanya Burr, spoken very eloquently about the dangers of that and how it's very easy to overshare.
Yeah, I mean, again, another really great question. I think it's important to stay true to yourself. I don't really believe in building a character and playing a role, because I think people see straight through it. I think your audience can tell when you're being authentic and when you're not. However, of course, there is a line, and there are parts of your life that you obviously need to keep behind closed doors. But I think the main important thing is being authentic and being true to yourself, and not trying to play a fake character in this world.
I'm curious for you personally, what is the best and the worst that YouTube has to offer?
Oh my God, best and the worst. I'll be honest, I don't have a worst. I'm so grateful for the platform that I've been given and YouTube as a whole. The best has got to be the types of people that I reach. You know, with a click of the button, I'm able to reach people on continents I've never been to, of all ages, all demographics, and it's just like a really incredible opportunity to be able to have. So yeah, it will definitely be the shareability and the fact that anyone can access this content anywhere in the world.